I'm Jeremy Daubert with the Rockingham County Extension Office and Dairy Extension Agent for the Shenandoah Valley. I'm here today with Clay Shiflet from Rockingham County Fire and Rescue. And we're here for Farm Safety Week and talk a little bit about manure pit safety today. So one part of my job is just general farm safety. So we can come out to farms and help local producers sort of make assessments on their farms. We can just put another set of eyes and see where things can be improved or changes and just to make the farm more safe. So you can see a manure pit behind us here. So we'll just walk around and look and see, make sure, you know, all the gates are chained, make sure there's signs where there needs to be. Talk to the farmers about how to make their farm safer.
So we get more into the response aspect. Like you said, my name is Clay Shiflet. I'm with Rockingham County Fire and Rescue, Battalion Chief. We are in a large agriculture area here in Rockingham County and the Shenandoah Valley, for that matter. And unfortunately, we have had to respond to several farm incidents. So it's our goal to work with the extension agency to try to prevent those from happening in the first place.
Yeah, so the first thing is just to be aware of what dangers are on the farm. Your first strategy is to eliminate the danger. Of course, on a dairy farm, manure can cause gases that are toxic, and you're not going to eliminate manure on a dairy farm, so you can't eliminate it. So what can we do after that? So things like this fence around this manure pit is the first line of defense, basically. Making sure gates are chained. Put signs up that just warn people that, hey, there could be toxic gases around. And then knowing the gases that can be produced in a manure pit, when they're more often could be found. So for instance, hydrogen sulfide is a gas that's extremely toxic. It's very heavy. It sits near the ground. 75 degrees is sort of the optimal temperature for that. Farms that use gypsum for bedding have a higher instance of finding that gas. And like I said, it's heavy. So usually you find it when the manure pits are agitated and that gas kind of gets released. If the manure pit's full, the gas will come down along the side of the manure pit. So somebody standing around the manure pit on a lower level, children that are lower to the ground could be more susceptible to it because that gas will sit lower to the ground. If it's an enclosed pit, making sure that nobody goes in there without some respiratory protection, make sure the ventilation is good. So we can talk to the farmers about all these things, just making sure that they have everything they need on the farm to be safe.
And I'll say in terms of the calls that we have ran in the past has been the enclosed manure pits, the ones that are underground underneath of a dairy parlor or those type in general, has been the ones that lack the ventilation that we have had troubles in the past with safety events that we've had to respond to. Like you said, the hydrogen sulfide, it doesn't take a whole lot to be dangerous. And those levels get very high, especially in the underground ones. But like you said, even when they're agitating them to spread onto the fields, just being heavier, it can settle around and affect people. Even an open pit like this with the wind blowing can still be dangerous on a day that you're agitating.
So it's important for farms to know if you have an enclosed pit, like Clay said, that's often where their calls come from. You know, somebody goes in and there's not enough ventilation. And they get overcome by the fumes, and then somebody follows them in to rescue them. But it's important to have, if you're going in one of those pits, to have a harness on, have somebody up above that's monitoring the person that's going in, so if somebody does pass out, they can pull them out. Make sure there's ventilation, run fans in there. If the pit's not set up with automatic ventilation, you know, manually put a fan in there and blow air in to get fresh air in there before anybody even attempts to go in. There's also monitoring devices where you can test the air to make sure the oxygen levels are high enough and it doesn't have any toxic gases.
And that's one part that we have come in with on farms, helping farmers out, is if they don't have a meter or we can help them find a place to get a meter. All of our apparatus carry what we call a four-gas meter that monitors for hydrogen sulfide and oxygen levels. To kind of tag on what he said about the ventilation, the one thing with the hydrogen sulfide being heavier than air is making sure you're getting that ventilation down deep enough. Some specialty fans actually have tubes that you can get them all the way to the bottom to make sure you're agitating that air in there enough to stir it up instead of just taking that top level off.
Yeah, and it's better to be preventative. You know, like Clay said, they have the meters that can test it, and I'm sure he'd much rather come out to a farm and test the farm, make sure the air is safe, than to come out afterwards after there's an accident.
Yeah, and we've done that several times for farmers. I mean, I can't speak for other areas and what the fire departments will do, but I know just trying to work with our community around here, we've done it several times just to keep them safe. And, you know, and it's not just the hydrogen sulfide. I mean, methane is produced, and you get in a confined underground storage tank, it can get to a level where it's explosive as well. So, like I said, ventilation is key, making sure that somebody knows you're in there, you're not going in by yourself, and that you have means to get yourself out. If you were to become incapacitated, you have a harness on with a rope attached or some type of means to lift you out of there if something was to happen. Yeah, and one of the more important things is making sure that if somebody does become incapacitated is that you call 911. Don't go in after them. You'll become the next victim if you go in as well. That's the importance of having a harness to get them out without having to go in. So often we have ran calls to where one after another goes in. It's been several years, but we ran a call where five family members actually went in one after the other and all passed away because of it. And luckily there was somebody around to call 911, but it was too late at that point. But instead of just losing one life, we lost five, which is unfortunate. So.
Yeah, and that's, you know, one of the reasons why it's so good doing these educational webinars and just talking with your extension agent, your local fire and rescue, you know, just so everybody on the farm understands. You know, it's, you know, we go through this every couple of years, but there's a new generation of kids coming up that are working on the farm and maybe they don't fully understand. So it's important to remind children as they're working on the farm at any age, whether they're, 10 years old or 15 years old, just to remind them every year the dangers and what can happen, remind them to have access to call 911 if there is an accident, and some of the safety precautions that they can take.
And we talk a lot to folks on the farm and in and around agriculture in general is it's easy to become complacent. You know, you think, well, I'll just go down here and do this real quick, it won't take me long, and not take the extra steps to ventilate or make sure somebody's in there, and then it's too late. You know, take the extra minute or two. Make sure that the places that you're going into is ventilated. Make sure somebody knows you're there. You know, I can't stress that enough. I know we seem like we've talked about that a lot, but it's important to make sure you've got a means to get out, because it doesn't take a lot of the gas. Not only is it the gas, but it also displaces oxygen. So not only are you in a toxic environment, but now you're in a toxic environment without oxygen. So it's just, you know, take the extra minute or two, take the safety precautions, and make sure that you're covered. And to kind of tie in, if someone does become incapacitated and you do have a means to get them out, you know, they put a harness on and you have a rope and you're able to pull them out of the hole, their biggest problem at that point is their respiratory tract. They become overcome, they become anoxic. The most important thing is CPR, you know, getting them oxygen back in. And we're in a day and age that hands-only CPR is acceptable. And just the compressions alone is enough to get some fresh air, some ventilation into their lungs, to get them hopefully back on the right track before first responders and paramedics can get there.
Yeah, and it's a good idea on farms if they have if they're able to have oxygen tanks available just in case of an accident. I know a lot of farms don't have that. You know, they might have a fire extinguisher because everybody's sort of more familiar with fires happening on farms, but having an oxygen tank available for something like this to get oxygen into the patient is very helpful. All right. Yeah. Thanks, Clay, for being here today, for the, you know, doing this recording. And this ties into the FARM program that your co-op works with. And we're going to turn it over to Marisa Little.
Thanks, Jeremy. Hi, I'm Marisa Little, Sustainability Specialist for Maryland, Virginia Milk Producers. The Farm Workforce Development Evaluation is a resource to help develop and implement workforce safety among the farm, whether it deals with animal handling, chemical use, machinery, especially PTO safety, even manure pit safety. The evaluation guide helps the producer to develop and implement those best safety practices. The tips that Jeremy and Clay just gave you could help the producers with the implementation and the development of best safety practices on farm, whether it's knowing where the first aid kit is, to knowing where oxygen tanks, what CPR is, and how to implement CPR and or harnesses to retrieve somebody out of a grain tank or manure tank. With having these best safety practices implemented on the farm, it reduces overall risk for major injury no matter what aspect of the farm you're working at. Whether it is the animal handling, chemical safety, and or machinery. Here at Maryland, Virginia, the sustainability staff is always geared to help implement any kind of best safety practices and help you manage them through the FARM program. So please feel free to reach out to your local sustainability specialists.